大家好，我是 Paul， 周一到周五英文一起读。你有没有想过 Elon Musk 的一天是怎么样子的呢？Elon Musk 你知道吗？就特斯拉的老板或者 SpaceX 啊，送人上火星啊这些的。那他的一天，他有这么多公司要 run， 他的一天是怎么过的？所以这个影片大概没多久以前，那至少好像我没有看到把它翻成中文版的这个 attempt。那我们接下来看一下。那我发现到另外一件事情，就是在我过去的介绍影片中，我常常会不小心把影片很简单的部分也花费很多功夫去解释，所以我会尽量 refrain myself from that， 尽量克制自己，不要把简单的句子也一定要把它停下来翻译给你听。所以我们抓一些觉得比较重要的片语类的单字类的东西，或者甚至句型类的，我们来检讨一下下，大概也就可以了。好，所以我直接已经跳到了他开始说他一天的开始的部分，我们就听下去。
Let's start right at the beginning of the day. For Elon Musk, that starts at 7 a.m. Musk makes sure that he will get 6 to 6.5 hours of sleep each night.
所以你每天晚上睡多久？你可能睡，我睡六个小时、五个小时、七个小时、八个小时。I have 6 hours of sleep. 所以你可能会想说，I sleep 6 hours， 也没有说错。也没有说错。So how long do you usually sleep? Oh, I sleep for about 6 hours. That's fine. So I get 6 or 7 hours of sleep. 就换个说法。所以希望同学可以在你这个说法上可以稍微有点弹性一点点。
Through a bit of trial and error, he found that this is the perfect amount of sleep for him.
So 前面说的 through a bit of trial and error, he found that this is a perfect amount for him. 所以透过了一些 through 一些，我们用 through 也写下去好了。So through trial and error, 他发现六小时、七小时左右是 the best amount of time, 最好的时间量。那什么是 trial and error? Error 是错， trial 是试验，所以总之就是试试看不对再调，试试看不对再调。所以这就是很土法炼钢的做科学的方式。假设今天这边有100个 sample， 这 sample 里面有其中一个 sample 可以治 COVID 好了。那你要用什么方法能够来确定哪一个 sample 是对的呢？没有别的方式，你就是哪一个试，直到100个都试完为止，这就叫做 trial and error， OK？
And he prioritizes it. He was quoted in a Reddit AMA as saying, "Sleep is really great. I find if I don't get enough sleep, I'm quite grumpy."
看到这里，我必须要卷回去这样也听一下，因为这边有点内容还不错。
Amount of sleep for him, and he prioritizes it.
He prioritizes it. 这个字我觉得很棒，你要学起来。所以他把这个睡眠呢、啊，就是放在很重要的位置。所以 prioritize 就是你的轻重缓急。好，最优先的事情就是你的 top priority。所以这个字也不好念，希望同学都可以把它学起来。Prior 这个字更是你也应该知道 ，prior 就是在什么先前。所以什么东西走在什么东西的前面，表示它重要度比较高嘛。So if something gets priority over something else, it's more important.Okay, so he prioritizes sleep. 所以他把睡眠是优先化的这样子。
He was quoted in a Reddit AMA.
所以他在一个 Reddit AMA 里面有被大家 quote 一下，所以他曾经就被引言过他在 AMA 里面说的这句话。什么是 AMA 啊？这是 Reddit 里面一个很知名的一个活动。这个活动 AMA 就叫做 Ask Me Anything. 所以有些名人会到 Reddit 上说：“来，我现在要 host 一个 AMA。”所以大家就蜂拥上去，然后什么都能问，那他就什么都会回答。Ask me anything。所以很多名人都在上面做过这件事情，所以他也在 Reddit 的 AMA 上面回答过下面这一句话
：As saying, sleep is really great. I find if I don't get enough sleep, I'm quite grumpy.
呀，他要是睡不够，他会 grumpy。Grumpy 的意思就是起床气，就是有点、很不开心哈，不太爽 ，grumpy。这 OK 吧
？I could drop below a certain threshold of sleep, although I would be awake more hours, I would get less done.
刚这句也很棒。
I could drop below a certain threshold of sleep.
I could drop below a certain threshold of sleep. 他的确可以把他的睡眠降到某一个什么东西呢？这里有一个词叫 threshold. Threshold 怎么翻译？门槛。所以他可以睡到五个小时、四个小时的门槛。那但是虽然说我会醒着小时比较多，但是他却会。做比较少的工作，就而且这个做比较少的工作，这是一个很通俗的英文中的用法，用的是被动式。So although I would be awake more hours， 逗点 ，I would get less done。大家听懂哈？所以虽然说我醒着时间比较长，可是它的这个 productivity 反而会比较低 ，I would get less done。希望你有听懂这边的部分。所以它的 productivity， 它的本身的生产力 反而会比较低。好，听下去。
Although I would be awake more hours, I would get less done because my mental acuity would be affected.
啊，因为他的精神上的这个 acuity 把它翻译成是敏锐度，所以精神上的敏锐度会被影响到。
After he's up and moving, Musk usually skips his breakfast. He finds that this will save him a bit of time in the morning. But
他跳过早餐不吃，因为有听到 skip. Okay.
This is not always the case. When he does eat, he makes sure it's a high protein meal. Like
好，但是他也不是都是啊，就有时候的确有吃东西的时候，他确保这是一个高蛋白质的 high protein meal.
An omelet, and he'll have it with a cup of coffee. After that, Elon will take part in what he considers his most important daily routine, a shower. You heard.
所以接下来是他最重要的 daily routine， 就是先洗一个澡。OK， 你没听错 ，You heard that right.
Heard that right. One of the richest men on the planet's secret daily routine is to hop in the shower. He claims that while he's hosing off, that's when some of his best ideas come to him.
好，当他是 hose off 的时候 ，hose 就是你知道那个花洒的那个水龙头，那个水管，所以这个就是 hose。所以水管一般可能是 pipe， 可是这种软管我们往往叫它 hose。所以 garden hose 就是花园里面那一种软水管，所以他在 hose off 自己就是嘶嘶嘶嘶这样子 ，OK， 应该蛮容易懂的。
And believe it or not, there's some science to back this up. Shelley H. Carson, a researcher and psychologist at Harvard University, and author of Your Creative Brain, a book all about unlocking your imagination and productivity, has stated taking a bit of time off from a problem is the best way for your brain to find the solution to it. She goes on to say that by focusing on whatever problem is in front of you for too long, you may develop inherent bias.
All right， 所以刚刚讲一些都蛮废话的，我觉得，就是说，反正你让自己去多休息，就 steer clear of your problems， stay away from your problems temporarily， 你可能会反而更有生产力一点，还是之类的这样。好，然后我们再看下去。
Can spark new parts of the brain， and this in turn will task。
刚有一点有一些词我想要走一下下，好。
Inherent biases， and that will keep you think。
Inherent biases.
If a problem is in front of you for too long, you may develop inherent biases.
Yeah, 所以你要是 focus 在一个问题太久的话，你可能会发展出一些什么东西啊 ？Inherent biases， 这是很棒的一个词，就是内建的，就是与生俱来的。我们用 inherent 或者 intrinsic 这两个字都可以，这两个字都大概是托福雅思程度的字。OK， 但也不是说这两个字真的很难，因为说真的啊，也会在生活中听得到。OK， 像我记得我以前介绍过，我们说那个 cryptocurrency 就是虚拟货币，本身是没有任何价值的，它就只是一组电脑里面的数字而已，对不对？一组码而已。然后这个码能卖什么鬼啊？哦，可是它如果是代表着虚拟货币，它就可以卖多少多少钱呢？所以它本身没有价值，但是我们赋予了它价值，所以 inherent， 所以你有一些内建的、内在的一些 bias， 那 bias 就偏见。所以 if you focus on a problem for too long, you may start developing inherent biases. 希望有听懂。
And that will keep you thinking in the same unproductive manner. But doing a simple task like taking a shower and lathering up your hair can.
所以做一些很简单的 task， 好比说洗个澡，然后 lathering up your hair。这个 lather 的意思就是去lather 应该怎么翻译啊？总之你把你的洗发精倒在头上去弄，这个动作就要 lather， 就是好简单一点。
Spark new parts of the brain, and this in turn can jumpstart some free association in your mind. Before you know it, you'll be more innovative, more productive, and more creative than before when you were a stinky, sweaty mess. And to think, Elon figured this one out on his own. What a guy! Another morning routine for Mr. Musk that is a bit more on the rarer side, but does indeed happen, is physical fitness. Although we do want to point out that when he appeared on Joe Rogan podcast, he confessed to Rogan, I wouldn't exercise at all if I could. Sounds like he's not much of a fan. But he does indeed get out and about. Musk.
OK, 所以刚刚讲了半天，简单就是说是他不太运动。OK, I don't really exercise. But he does indeed get out and about. So out and about 就是跑出去到处玩耍之类的 ，out and about， OK， 就在外面到处晃着这样。
Will lift weights, run, and has been known to take part in Taekwondo, karate.
好，所以他 lift weights 这边这个是一个很简单的一个词 ，lift weight 就是举重 ，OK， 分了两个字 ，All right， 然后他还会这个 Taekwondo， 那 Taekwondo 这个词其实就真的是音译哈、哦，就跆拳道 ，OK， 那你说那空手道怎么说 ？Karate， 或者把它念成 Karate。这都是日文或者是泰坤都不知道是不是韩文来着，但无所谓，这不重要。
Karate, Judo, and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu.
啊，所以刚的确有讲到 Karate, Karate, Taekwondo, Karate, Karate, Judo 就是柔道。 我们做那个奥运特辑那时候有讲到过，以及还有 Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu， 就是那个巴西柔术。所以这个 Jiu-Jitsu 明明就是中文的举级术哦，但是他们翻成了巴西柔术 Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu。All right。
Apparently, he likes to dance too, as evidenced by some of his, shall we say, unique dance moves that he.
所以他也喜欢跳舞。那由什么来佐证着？所以这边有一个片语，我们可能学着试试看，来再看一次。
Dance too, as evidenced by some of his.
有看到哈？所以 he likes to dance too, as evidenced by 后面这件东西。所以我们会写一个句子，什么什么怎样，然后我们就接 as evidenced by 什么再接下去，就由什么来做证明。所以这个 evidence 变成是一个被动的形容词，这个也算是在你看在这样的英文中是。就是算是老老实实的，像包括是做节目里面的那旁白式的，或者写作里面都能够用到这个用法。So something is 怎么样 as evidenced by 什么东西这样子。So he loves to dance too as evidenced by you know this thing that he's doing on the screen.
Shall we say unique dance moves? That
对他们说是很独特的 dance move， 事实上就是很 goofy， 所以他跳起来有点 goofy。Goofy 就是有点滑稽搞笑这样子。事实上，我们知道的那个狗啊，高飞狗就是这个名字 ，Goofy。OK。
He has displayed at a Tesla event, closing out his morning. Elon will see his kids off to school and then drive over to either Tesla or SpaceX, usually in his Tesla Model X, a $79,990 car. Moving on to the midday of this billionaire, we find that he splits his time fairly evenly between his two largest companies, Space.
好，所以他 splits his time fairly evenly。Evenly 在这两个公司间 ，between X and B， 所以他把他的时间分在这两个不同的公司里，所以他用 split 这个字 ，split 就是从中间分开，所以 split his time evenly 就是很平均的，他也强调是 fairly evenly。前面还有一个部分我刚没有停下来，就是他会把他小孩送去上学 ，so he sees his children to school， 所以他甚至没有用 send， 他用就是 see， 他看着孩子们去上学了，简单的说。所以他用 see 这个动词来用这件事情，所以蛮有趣的、哦。
SpaceX and Tesla, with Tesla winning out ever so slightly in terms of weekly hours.
好，所以两间公司分的时间蛮平均，但是
and Tesla, with Tesla winning out ever so slightly.
所以，但是 Tesla 分到的时间会比较多 ，with Tesla winning out ever so slightly. 所以 Tesla winning out slightly 其实也就够了。要想要强调一下这个语气 ，ever so slightly. 所以我们这里就可以稍微说一下，有些英文上的那种，像我如果今天我很常去，一个地方，我很常去健身房 ，so I go to the gym very often， 对不对？那能不能这边也像刚刚这里的强调语气一样，能不能就 ever so often？ 不是不行，只是就你的构句要稍微思考一下是怎么用就是了 ，OK。
In terms of weekly hours, for Musk, 42 hours of his week are spent at Tesla and.
Wow， 所以42小时。花在 Tesla， 一个人工作通常全职也就是42小时了耶，所以你看他绝对不是一个礼拜工作42小时而已的。
40 are at SpaceX，
40个小时在 SpaceX， 哇、wow, ，所以他一个礼拜就已经工作80小时了，我们一般人的两倍。
And when he's at work, oh boy, you can bet he's giving it his full focus. Musk has stated he's not as good about his nutrition as he should be, and many times he will scarf down his lunch during an afternoon meeting. Speaking of meetings。
所以他有时候就是吃的部分没有那么讲究 ，OK？ 所以这里有一个动词片语叫 scarf down his lunch。
Musk hates them, and honestly, we don't blame him.
Speaking of meetings， 讲到会议啊，他讨厌开会，那我们不能怪他，因为开会事实上我们知道常常很浪费时间。所以刚刚的片语也稍微说一下 ，scarf down something 就是很快的吃下去。
He has his time at work perfectly scheduled out, and meetings, they just get in the way of all the good stuff, like the engineering of his cars, making sure that they look and feel perfect, and also making sure his factories are running as efficiently as possible. Musk hates meetings so much that he has even sent out a list of rules about them to his workers. Large meetings are banned unless they are absolutely necessary.
好，他刚前面讲部分就是总是在多讨厌 meetings 啦，所以这边说的是大型的会议 are banned， 根本就禁止了。除非 unless they are absolutely necessary， 除非是完全的非常有必要才一定要开。
Frequent meetings are a no-no as well, and are only allowed if a matter is urgent.
好，所以什么什么事情是个 no-no 就是不要。So if something is a no-no， 就是很可爱的一种说法，就是不可以这样子。所以一样，除非是非常的 urgent 才可以。
Any and everyone is allowed to walk out of a meeting at any time as soon as they realize they aren't needed.
哈哈哈，这个好酷哦。所以任何人或者每一个人都可以随时从一个会议中离开，只要他们了解到我在这个会议里已经不被需要了，就我的部分谈完了，拜，我就走了。所以这句我们再听一次，真是很酷。
Me and everyone is
any and everyone is allowed
to walk out of a meeting at any time as soon as they realize they aren't needed.
As soon as they realize they aren't needed， 一旦他们知道他们没有被需要就可以走了。
Musk doesn't want anyone to waste their time due to formalities. Finally,
formality， 所以他不喜欢大家有一种哦，我们有个仪式的正式感。所以这个 formality 就这样的概念。OK。Formality， 我很想举一些例子，像例如说，假设我跟你早就内定了，你是我们下一个公司想要签的一个签合同的一个对象，那但是我们还是要你来我们公司见一下我们老板，然后我拿那个合约念一下给你听，那让你给你五分钟读一下，然后才让你签，所以这些都已经变成是一个 formality， 我们早就已经讲好你会签了。所以这个就叫做 we still have some formality to go through。大家听懂意思啊？
There is a ban on acronyms or nonsense words for objects, software, or processes at Tesla. The idea here is that anyone should be able to talk to anyone else in any department, and information shouldn't be stopped just because one department uses jargon that another isn't familiar with.
啊，这个也好酷哦！我忍不住想要再让你听一次，讲的有点长。这边说的是。他们在公司里面是禁止一个东西叫做 acronym， 有很多什么 num 结尾的字，例如说 synonym 叫做同义字 ，OK， 那然后 antonym 叫做反义字，那所以这边讲了一个 acronym 是什么呢？缩写。那尤其是它会缩成一个字的时候叫做缩写，要是缩起来不是一个字就不叫做缩写。像举个例子 ，NBA 叫做 National Basketball Association， 可是 NBA 是一个字吗？不是一个字。所以这就不叫做 acronym， OK， 它只叫做 abbreviation。如果合起来可以是一个字，例如说你想一个东西叫什么 MOP 好了，所以可能是什么moving object 什么 project 还是什么这些的三个字合起来合成了 MOP 这个字，那 MOP 这个字叫拖把 mop， 哎，这个就是一个 acronym， 听懂我意思哈？好，所以在公司是禁止。Acronym 的为什么
？Acronyms or nonsense words for objects, software, or processes.
所以对于一些或者 acronym 或者一些没有意义的字 ，nonsense 的一些字都是被禁止的。所以什么东西物这 objects 啊，或者是 software 软件啊，或者是一些工作上的程序是不可以用一些缩写字去称呼它的。
At Tesla, the idea here is that anyone should be able to talk to anyone else.
所以任何人都应该可以跟另外的别人讲话，就跨部门要可以沟通。如果你的部门用一些特别的词的话，那别的部门不懂，那是不 OK 的。所以他要确保大家的 communication 都非常 clear， 所以禁止用这一些词。
Any department and information shouldn't be stopped just because one department uses jargon that another isn't familiar with.
Right? So, 一个 department 用了一些 jargon that another department is not familiar with. That is not okay.所以 jargon 这个词就是一些艰深的、让人家不懂的话，这样子 ，OK。
In total, Musk has claimed he works 120-hour work weeks.
哇，他一个礼拜工作120个小时 ，That's just insane, OK?
But boy, does it pay off on average?
Boy, does it pay off? 所以哇，那但是天哪，他的120个小时还真的有 pay off。这里 pay off 的意思就真的有回报。OK， 还真有代价，有回来，不要讲代价，有回报。OK，
per day， Elon will make $383 million。
他一天会赚3800多万，不对，我有讲错了，3亿多万，有没有讲错啊？我们再回头卷一次啊。
Average per day， Elon will make $383 million。
真的是 OK， 百万千万亿，他一天赚3亿多。That's crazy. Okay, 3.8亿.
We're starting to feel like we aren't working hard enough. How about you? We feel like we have to say this though. Elon knows he works a bit much. He has gone on record to say there were times when I didn't leave the factory for 3 or 4 days.
所以他也说他 overwork. Okay, 他说有3-4天 for 3 or 4 days, 他就根本没有离开 factory. 很扯. Okay, 很扯。
Days when I didn't go outside. This has really come at the expense of seeing my kids and seeing friends.
So this has come at expense of 什么东西？所以这个东西啊，就是以我看我的孩子跟看我的朋友以为代价这样子。So something comes at the expense of something else. 所以也就是 X 这件事情是以 Y 为代价了。所以他的这么多的 overwork 呢，就以 看孩子以及看朋友或做社交为代价。那 expense 就是开销之类的意思。所以 Y 啊就等于像，所以 Y 的部分就等于说是你把它变成像是一个你花掉的东西，你得不回来的这样子。
He's eased up recently, and it's more common for him to do 80 to 90 hour work weeks.
所以他现在已经放轻松了，他可能现在一个礼拜八九十小时而已了。
He's an avid gamer with Cyberpunk 2077, a game that brought in $563 million in total sales revenue, being one of his favorites. He has also tweeted that one and only one console game has stolen his heart.
只有一个 console game 偷了他的心，这个 console 的字就是我们讲说的游戏机，因为刚刚讲 Cyberpunk 是可以用 PC 上玩的嘛，所以我猜他是在 PC 上玩。但只有一个 console game 偷了他的心，就是这里讲 Only Halo。Halo 就是哇，就是那个士官长那个游戏，我都不知道中文叫什么啊。
And it was Halo. Other than that, Elon will be sure to read. There are claims that he will finish 2 books a day, listen to podcasts and audiobooks. And
所以他晚上还有那么多时间呢，他。可以一天读两本书，然后听 podcast 什么这些。
And throw the occasional party. We're not sure how big a party he'll manage in his 400 square foot home, but we don't think that will stop him. He once rented a castle in England where the guests played hide and seek. If
曾经有一次租了一个 castle， 然后宾客有人在里面玩躲猫猫。Gosh，
that's not a way to spend your 30th birthday. We don't know what is.
三十岁的时候办 party 了，简单的说。好，我们看到这里真的也够了，这一集做的也够长了。所以这就是 Elon Musk 的一天，我还是不太能够 fathom， 这 fathom 这个字就不能够吞得下去理解它。所以 fathom， there's something that I can't fathom， and that is how can you work over 120 hours a week？ 你怎么有办法一个礼拜工作超过120个小时啊？ This is beyond comprehension。40个小时一周，一天就8小时了，那你一天也不过24小时。要是你一天做工作16个小时好了，那也不过变成了80个小时啊，这120个小时到底哪里来的？ I really don't get it. But that's him. 好，那我们到这里就够了。我是 Paul， 我们下次见。